Especially during COVID-19. Wash your hands every time you enter your home, especially. The Prophet has said, cleanliness is half of faith. This is mentioned in Sahih Muslim, Hadith number 223.
Tune in to Reflections, weekdays at 7:45 p.m. Only on Tracks FM.
I am a voice given and crying loud. Please sound.
This is Tracks FM.
Be mindful of Allah, for Allah's punishment is severe. Human beings depend on each other. There are no creatures in this world that need each other as much as human beings need each other. Unless someone is living in jungle, inside in caves, and surviving on some wild fruit, no one who lives in any village or city can survive without any help from others. The Arab poet said long time ago, people with a desert between or city dwellers, they are all servants of each other. If they actually do not realize it, the British historian Rahman Ibn Khaldun wrote in his famous Iman that social life is necessary for humankind. Without it, their existence will not be concrete and they cannot fulfill the purpose for which God created them and sent them to this earth. Working together is necessary for human survival and for human progress. In the terminology of Quran, it is called ta'awun. Ta'awun means helping and supporting each other. However, Islam emphasizes that cooperation must be in what is right and good, not toward what is sinful and hostile. The ethic of cooperation in Islam is that Muslims should cooperate with others regardless of whether they are Muslim or non-Muslim, as long as the purpose or the objective of the cooperation is the right and the good one. On the other hand, Muslims are not allowed to cooperate with any person or group, whether they are Muslim or non-Muslim, if the
be sinful, unjust, and hostile. We have a very beautiful example of this principle in the life of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is reported that while he, peace be upon him, was living in Makkah, before receiving the prophethood, he joined an alliance known as Half al-Fudul. The Prophet and some good people of Makkah met an Abdullah ibn Jud'an and made an agreement. The agreement says, if they found anyone, either a native of Makkah or any outsider, had been wronged, they would take his part against the aggressor and see that the stolen property was restored to him. May Allah guide us and strengthen our relationship within people in our society, regardless of Muslim or non-Muslim. That's all for today. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum.
Thank you.
Turn them down. Snap them on the hook.